The No AIDS Task Force is offering free HIV testing at this mobile unit in conjunction with the U.S. Conference on AIDS. It's one step in an effort to reach out to the city's most at-risk population.
Yeah.
Gina Brown, a New Orleans resident, has lived with HIV for 19 years.
I was pregnant with my daughter in 1994 when I was diagnosed. So, of course, I had a lot of internal stigma. I had a lot of bad things that I thought about myself.
Though she did not pass the virus on to her daughter, she's now an advocate with AIDS United, working to erase the stigmas associated with HIV and AIDS.
A lot of people don't even think they're at risk for HIV. And we talk to them and we tell them all the time that to get HIV, all you have to do is not use a condom, and you're at risk.
The U.S. Conference on AIDS being hosted in New Orleans this year is the largest AIDS-related gathering in the nation. This year, it's aimed at addressing a lack of education about HIV, especially in the southern region.
Yet we're facing the stigma, people not wanting to talk about the importance of both preventing as well as treating HIV, and they really pose unique challenges.
The National Minority AIDS Council estimates there are at least 50,000 new infections a year in the country, with over 7,173 people living with HIV in the New Orleans metro area. Advocates say contributing factors are high rates of poverty, little education, and a lack of access to available life-saving resources.
It's definitely really important that we all come together, that our churches, that our schools, that everybody works together to get the message out there to both prevent and treat.
Officials say the keys to prevention is having open conversations with your partner, as well as learning the truth about HIV and AIDS and getting tested. On your side, I'm Casey Ferran, WDSU News.
And we put a link on our website, WDSU.com, with a list of places where you can get AIDS and HIV testing.